Pelota, the Spanish word for ball. Welcome to another beautiful day here in Chile. Today is a special day because I'm going to teach you all about roosters and hens. It's going to be a great day, so let's go. So in order to tell you about the rooster and the hen, I feel like I have to go back to 1979. Because in 1979, Chile adopted this dance as their national dance. And so the rooster, the male, tries to snag a quick date with the hen, the girl. And the dance is all about that. And the guy gets a little aggressive sometimes, but very respectful. The girl then makes the guy go around in circles, and they chase each other for a while until the guy finally gets the girl. So if you haven't figured it out yet why I'm talking about a rooster and a hen, well, you've never been to Chile before, because in September, the rooster and the hen, well, they dance a lot together, and the dance is called the cueca. Today, we're having a cueca competition, and it's gonna be epic.
La consentida, porque todo consigue en mi vida con sus porfías, porque todo consigue.
Expert on the cueca. However, in this region here, it is something really, really special because everyone dances it, especially in the schools. The kids learn how to dance it when they're in pre-kinder, and they continue to dance it all throughout high school, and then there are competitions during grade school, during high school, and afterwards, and during the September month, it gets really, really serious. This was just the first competition, but there will be many, many more. And it's such a cool thing for me because it is Chile. To me, the cueca is Chile because it's from our region that we're living in right now in Linares. And the families and the kids get so, so excited about it. But I would say that the cueca is the national dance. However, it's more common in the area that we live in the Maule region. You see, in this Maule region, it is all about the hens and the roosters. Because it is all farmland. And it's really beautiful to me, but I feel like that has something to do with why the cueca is so common, especially in this middle area of Chile. But I think that the cueca dance is significant for a lot of reasons. Because there are a lot of you who are watching my vlogs from far away, and maybe you grew up with this cueca dance. And if you did, it brings back some cool memories, or maybe some not so good memories of losing competitions, but at least of watching this cueca, the songs that come with it, and it's just a special time when you think of the cueca, you think of the month of September. Not just the 18th of September, but the entire month. So because we're talking about the cueca today and the national dance, especially common in this region, I figured I'd show you what it's like in this region. And yesterday I went out to the mountains and we saw spectacular views. Go check that video out right up here. But today we are in the normal part. We're close to Linares, but a little further away in Longaví. And well, they say the cueca came from this area right here. So I'm going to show you this area right here. It is beautiful. But if you ever do get the opportunity to come to the Maule region, you have to check out the Cueca, and you have to come during the September month because it is something really, really special to Chile, and everybody in this region does it. Other regions do it still, but this region goes nuts for the Cueca. It's something really, really special and really cool. All right, so we finally reached my favorite part of the episode, which is not necessarily showing the dogs, but it is talking about the Cueca and learning from you. You see, I'm a gringo, and I'm from the United States and never grew up with the Cueca. And a lot of you are from the United States as well, and you don't know much about the Cueca besides what I just told you. So, if you are from Chile and have some experience with the Cueca, and it brings back some childhood memories, go ahead and write those childhood memories right below in the description. I want to learn from you, and I want others from the United States, South Africa, other places in Europe to learn from you as well. What is the Cueca? What does it mean to you? And how did it affect you growing up? Leave all of the comments right below. I am interested to learn from you. But I hope you enjoyed the video as much as I enjoy putting it all together. Check me out on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. But for now, enjoy the sunset, leave some comments below, and we'll see you guys next time for another adventure. Ciao, Pascal.